So hello everyone. So in this video we will be learning about stacks and queue. Okay, so we will see how we can implement stack and queue in C++ using the str library. So what is str library? So C++ has provided a standard template library which actually has this inbuilt functions which are stack, queue, array and all this. Okay, so you can use all the data structures directly using the str library. So what you have to do is you have to just include either this particular header, which is include bit slash stdc++.h, or you can, what you can do is you can exclude this, and rather include, just like you do. And if you are using stack, you can use stack like this. If you are using queue, you can use queue like this. Okay, so you can use the individual libraries, or you can, if you are using the entire package, then not required. Okay, these things. Okay, so now before going further, what is stack? Okay, what is stack? So stack is actually, imagine a set of plates. Okay, so a set of dishes kept one after another. Okay, so when you put the last one, that's at the bottom. Okay, and the first one is at the top, which so it's first in, last out. Okay, or last in, first out. So the last one which has went in the stack, that will be the first one to come out. Okay, and in queue, okay, we will look into queue after we look into stack. Okay, so now let's see how we can implement this. So we will create a stack, let's say stack. Okay, so we have a stack. Okay, so we created a stack. Now we have initialized it, and now we can start pushing the data inside stack. Okay, so why we will be using stack? We can use array also, right? But what's the limitation is, as you might know, array you have to declare a fixed size. Okay, so but that's not the case with stack, queue or linked list, all this. Okay, so you have so this actually gives a dynamic memory allocation, so you are freed from that. If you have to write a program, let's say you have to initially think what's the size, so you can use stack and you don't need to bother about what the size will be. Okay, so stack this. Now stack dot push, let's say 30. Stack dot push 31. Stack dot push 32. Stack dot push, just putting some values. Okay, so now we have these values inside the stack. Okay, these are pushed inside the stack. That means you are like keeping the plates on one on top of the other. Okay, now let's say you want to pop it. Okay, you want to remove an element from the stack. How do you do? Let's say you just write pop, and that should pop the element from the stack. And let's say you want to print the first element in the stack. How do you do that? You write cout, let's say stack.top. So what should it print? First element is this, so the last one which is gone inside the stack was 34, so that will be the first one to come out. Okay, so it will be 34. Okay, so that's how it works. Okay, now let's say you want to print the elements in the stack. How will you do that? While not stack.empty, which means while there are elements in the stack, what you do, you print one by one. So okay, so what you do, stack dot top So you print one and then we give a space, okay, just for so that there is a gap in between. And then once this is printed, we remove that from the stack. Okay, so what will happen is one by one, this will get removed. This will get printed, this will get removed. This will get printed, this will get removed. Ultimately, the stack will be empty. Okay, so this loop will stop then. Okay, so let's run and see. So if you notice, this is actually getting printed from 34, 32, 31 and 30. Okay, so because the last one which has gone in will be the first one which has come out. Okay, so that is stack. Now looking at queue. Okay, what is queue? Queue is just like you are, let's say, in a shopping center and you have purchased something and waiting in a line. Okay, then the first one who went inside in the line will be the first one to come out in the line. Okay, so if you are the first one to go in the line, okay, you will be the first one to come out. Okay, so that is first in, first out. That's queue. Okay, so how do you implement queue over here? Just same as stack. Okay, it's just same as stack. You write queue. Okay, so same as stack. Okay, but the function name here will be front. Okay, so the it won't be top, it will be front, and rest will be same. Okay, but one thing you will notice is earlier it was 34, 32, 31 and 30, but here the first which has gone in is 30, so first will be coming out will be also 30, then will be 31, then will be 32, then will be 34. So let's see. Okay, we haven't changed the name yet. Okay, from here. Okay, one more is there. So now if we run it, so if you notice something over here, it's 30, 31, 32 and 34. Earlier it was 34, 32, 31 and 30. So this is actually printing the first one which was the first one which entered and first one which is coming out. Okay, so this is stack and queue. So very short, but I believe you like this video. So thanks guys, bye.